Hey guys, Rob Baldwin here, IMX Productions, 10 Minute Design. Welcome to a brand new tutorial. Something we've done before, but a little different, a little new twist to it. Okay, so here we are. Here's a image of a model with a blank t-shirt. What we want to do is get our t-shirt design onto that shirt. And this is a technique. What I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to make a template, how to make this so you can reuse it without having to redo all of the steps over and over. So we do the steps once, then we reuse it for multiple shirts. Okay, so step one, what we want to do is get ourselves kind of a grid image like this. I just found this on Google. It's just basically to create that template. We want it to basically be kind of maximum printable area. So, okay, so if you think of your t-shirt, what is the maximum printable area? That's the size of your grid. So I don't want to necessarily be the size of the shirt you're designing, of that particular design, but of the maximum printable area. Okay, keep that in mind. So first thing we're gonna do is take our grid, we're gonna right click and come up here to convert to smart object. What smart object is it allows you to make all sorts of changes to it, but it keeps that original design in kind of an embedded separate Photoshop document. So, you know, it sounds a little weird if you're not familiar with them, but we'll get there. Okay, so once you've done that, now you see this little icon down here, that means this is a smart object. We can now go ahead and hit the Command Control T for free transform. And we're gonna basically bring this down to our printable area. Okay, so what we wanna do is just have this match the model. That's about the printable area right there. Okay, now hit Command Transform again. We're gonna warp. Now what we wanna do is warp around the model until we kind of match the model's proportions as best we can. Okay. Now, I could be doing a much better job of this. You could spend a lot of time. You could kind of try out different designs and see what works best. I'm just, for the sake of this video, I'm gonna go a little fast. Okay, but you get the idea. I'm kind of just conforming to the model's shape, to the t-shirt and everything. Okay, double hit, place, boom, the file is there. Okay, now, the idea here is that this file, even though it's been warped, it's gonna keep that shape. If I double click on that, it loads a separate Photoshop document with that initial design. So whatever we do here, save, go back to our template, and it'll get added right back there. So here we go, we have a design. We've seen this design before. Cat owns the house. Control C on that one here. Come here, we're gonna paste that in there. And just make it slightly smaller. We want to hide the background grid design. We're done with that, we don't need it. Hit save, come back to our shirt template, and look at that, it perfectly conforms. It just basically took the place of that, that placeholder grid that we had, perfect. Okay, so, and of course, we could grab a different design, go back to this file. Okay, so if you closed it for whatever reason, simply come back here, double click, there we go, and simply place this. Now, of course, this is not a full printable area design, so I wanna make sure I place it at the appropriate place. We want it kind of across the chest, so right about here, hit save, come back to the template, and there it is. Okay, we could always move it around if you wanted to. I don't know why you would put it low, but just, you know, it gives you an idea. You get to play around with the positioning of your t-shirt. So whatever designs you do, you throw it in that template, it gets added to the shirt, okay? We're gonna go one step further. This looks good, but let's add some texture so that, because there's a fold in here, we want the design to look like it fits on the shirt, okay? So very quickly, here we go, I'm gonna select as closely as I can around the t-shirt, just like that. Doesn't have to be perfect, you'll see why. With the model layer selected, Control C, Control V, okay, or Command if you're on a Mac. I don't know why I keep saying Control, even though I'm on a Mac. Force of habit, I suppose. We're gonna go up here to Image, Adjustment, and Desaturate. That's gonna make my layer gray. We're gonna go back up to Image, Adjustment, and Curves. Now what I wanna do is bring it to a very contrasted white, but I want the primarily white. Try to make the t-shirt white, essentially. Keep the shadows in there, but make the t-shirt white. Okay, perfect. Okay, hit okay. And then what we want to do is bring it down to multiply. Multiply. Now look at that. It actually adds in the shading and everything around our design. So it really looks like it's embedded in the image. Now, of course, we're having some weird stuff happening here. So what we simply want to do is with Command or Control selected, select our T-shirt layer. It's going to select just the T-shirt. We then have our shaded layer selected and hit the mask tool. And that's going to add a mask. So now it's simply applying those shadowing to the T-shirt layer. Okay, and now my T-shirt looks absolutely perfect. If we zoom in, you can really see the details right around here. See the lighting right here of the T-shirt fold and the shadowing right there. It really conforms properly to the T-shirt dimensions. Okay, so there you go. Of course, one last detail. If you do change your design from here, so if we go back to our second design, and I save that, come back here, well, look at that. We have to change the mask because now the mask is conforming to the old design. So simply delete that mask, Command and Control click the T-shirt design again, and then hit a new mask, and now we'll apply to our new mask. Okay, just that simple, guys. Now this template, you save it as a PSD file. It'll keep that embedded smart object, so you can keep reusing it for all your T-shirt designs. Of course, you can change the color of the T-shirt. That's another video. Okay, so check back soon, please. All right, check out some videos here on the channel. Don't forget to subscribe, just like the pillow says. Okay, subscribe to my channel and leave comments for suggestions. What videos would you like to see next? Okay, this is Rob Baldwin. Thanks for watching. Cheers.